Yeah, okay, cool. So it's fun to be here. My name is Caroline Arkansson, and I'm working as an Android developer at Spotify in Stockholm. And today I'm going to talk about how we created a hackathon with 50-50 female and male participants and how we learned to make a hackathon for a tech event for everyone. And I want you guys, you people, to get the like tips and tricks and inspiration to make even better tech events for all the cool people out there who want to hack and learn. So, back to the start. When I started working at Spotify 2 years ago, I was still a student, and I was working with student relations between Spotify and tech universities. And me and my colleagues, we were gonna make an event for students all over Sweden, and we were reflecting on why are there so few female students attending our events? Because it's not like they don't exist, we just didn't manage to reach out to them. So we started thinking, okay, how can we approach this? How can we learn how to reach out to all students out there? So we decided we were gonna make an amazing event. We were going to force a 50-50 gender division between female and male. We also wanted to reach out to first-time hackathoners because there are a lot of students out there who learn how to code while they're at the university, but maybe don't attend that many tech events because they're a bit scared or intimidated. And we wanted to say that this is a great event for you guys. And we also wanted to promote like the nice side of the tech world, like the inspirational, learning, warm part of a tech world, and not just that you would be like sitting in a basement or, you know, that kind of view. We wanted to take that part away from it. So we decided to make diversify with our motto, think it, build it, ship it, show it. So this was going to be not just a regular hackathon, it was going to be the hackathon focusing on creativity and learning and building something that you can show for others. So this is what we decided to do. For the teams, we decided that we wanted to have 40 participants because that's quite a big crowd, but it's still not too many, so you can still socialize with the people in the room. And we split them up into 10 teams, so 4 people in each team. Each team was going to be 50-50, female-male, and also cross-functional. So when they applied, they got to specify what they wanted to do, and we didn't want a team to get stuck because they were only like back-end developers, but they wanted design, and no one wanted to do the design or something like that. So every team had each skill set. They were also coached by Spotify employees. So since these are our participants were students, there are a lot of things that they don't know maybe because they haven't been hacking or designing that much. And we didn't want them to get stuck. We wanted them to get help, to like really feel like they could produce and learn something during these 2 days. And a bit about the format of the hackathon. How we like to schedule and how we set it up. So the purpose of Diversify was not to win. We thought that everyone who were there were already a winner because they made it through our screening process. And there were like no fancy prizes or anything. So we removed the competitive part to instead and promote that you're supposed to like talk to each other and show what you built. But also, if you're very new to programming or going to hackathons, the first event that you go to shouldn't be all about like, okay, well, I'm new and I'm nervous and this guy is so much better than me, or you know, that girl has been doing this for so many years and then it's just a competition and you lose and that's not very fun. Or so, no prizes, focusing on creating. We also decided to remove pitches. We didn't want our participants to spend their time on making a slide deck or making an ugly hack to get that one button that they're going to show in the presentation to work, but it actually doesn't work at all. So we wanted them to focus on building the product. So no pitches, but we had like demo stations instead. So each team had a table and you could go there and you could play around with what they built and you could ask questions and like maybe go look into the code if you wanted to. Oh, that's a neat solution. So more actually focus on the product and what they built and what they learned and not just doing 2-minute slideshow deck, because I mean, obviously, how fun is it? Not that much. You don't get that much understanding of the product that they built. We also at Spotify believe very much in knowledge sharing. So we had in the schedule, we put in like micro presentations every now and then, just like pass the microphone format. Each team got to say, okay, we've been working on this. This is our challenge right now. This button is not working, so we're trying to figure that out. So that every team that was there could also know, like, oh, but those people over there are building this cool collaborative playlist app, and they are doing a travel music app. That's fun. So everyone knew what the other ones were building. And that's so much more fun than, you know, someone just sitting in the corner like, no, this is my stuff, you're not allowed to see it. So we had that to promote knowledge sharing. We also didn't want our hackathon participants to just sit and like code until their eyes were bleeding or like really just focused in to on your computer, because when you're working with this, your brain kind of needs a rest every now and then. So we had two external speakers joining us, Christian Heilman from Microsoft and Heide Harman, a UX researcher from Lookback and co-founder of Geek Girl Meetup. They were both there and gave a talk on their view on diversity and also promoting like discussion and talk to the students. What do you guys think about gender diversity and how can we approach it? Because it was, after all, a diversity-focused event, and we wanted that to show as well through the schedule, and not just being it like some kind of facade and then people just coding, but we actually wanted the diversity approach of it to show. We also had a workshop. So this is Judith Schneider, who works at Spotify, who made a workshop for them. And so they were sitting like in a team of four. They were playing a card game. Then the team would split up and go work with another team and do the card game with them. But the new people they were playing with had another set of rules than they had, which they didn't know. So it was about meeting someone who plays with the other rules of a game and handling miscommunication, and instead of thinking, okay, this person is stupid, actually trying to figure out, okay, what's going on here. Also another way to have talk to people from other teams and having a good conversation and thinking. And the next thing that we also did, which I think is very important, is sleep. So when I'm tired, I don't work well at all. Something that might take me 5 minutes to solve when I'm rested might take me an hour to solve when I'm really tired. And I don't like working at 2 a.m. in the night, because then I'm just tired and I don't feel well. So I didn't want to promote that behavior amongst my hackathon participants, and I wanted them to go home and get some rest. So we actually closed in the evening, and we said, okay, now you have to go home and sleep for a few hours. We open again at 9 a.m. tomorrow. Welcome to go back for breakfast, but because, you know, how fun is it to go to an event and then on Monday morning you're like super tired because you didn't sleep at all or things like that. So sleep is always good. Always go and sleep when you're tired. So we had to do some work before the event, of course, as well, because we wanted to reach out to our participants. So this is a bit how we approached marketing and applications and screening. We worked with a company called Confetti to make a sign-up site, and we had a lot of information there and really tried to make it clear that, okay, we believe that diverse teams create the best products at Spotify. we're really trying to work for like inclusiveness and openness and put a lot of effort into, this is not about winning, this is for you to learn, this weekend is all about you having fun and enjoying tech and getting a nice product that you can show, and really bounce back and forth a lot, how should we write the text properly. We also, in the applications, we had our participants answering a few questions, because we wanted to make sure that we were reaching out to the right kind of people for this event and for Spotify. So we wanted people who are fun, have a good team player, you know, a good heart, and there to learn. So we asked them, first of all, like, why do you want to be a part of Diversify? Just to see, like, okay, what's in it for you? We also asked them, like, what area would you like to develop further skills in? Do you want to become a better programmer? Do you want to learn web development? Do you want to get ideas on design tools or whatever? We also asked them, what can you contribute with? Because we needed this when we were setting up the teams, right? If they were like, oh, I really, really, really want to design, then we were like, okay, that's a designer person. Then, and we could make sure that we had enough designers for each team. And then also, what is gender diversity to you? Why is it important? Because this was a diversity-focused event, and we wanted people to actually find this an important matter, and not just come and see our offices at Spotify. I think we did pretty well with our outreach. We had, from our applications, 43% female applicants and 57% male. We never had that many female students applying to any of our events before, so that was a good win for us. We managed to reach out to a lot of female students, a lot of first-time hackathoners, yay. Other good things when you're organizing hackathons. Okay, food. Food is really important for energy and happiness. A lot of tech events out there, they serve pizza and beer. And not everyone likes pizza and beer. Me, for example, I'm gluten intolerant. I can't even eat pizza or drink beer. And when I went to a tech event earlier this year, I got potato chips for breakfast. That's not a great start of my day. So we did have pizza and beer because some people like that, but we also made sure to have salads and sodas and maybe cider or donuts for those who want donuts, but also apples and carrot sticks or croissant, like really making sure that everyone, there was something for everyone to eat. And you know, you shouldn't have to go hungry. You need, you know, your brain needs fuel when you're working on things. That's really important. Another like nice thing, like a nice touch that we had is like soundtrack your hack. In the applications, we let people like fill in what song are you and why, because it's a pretty fun way to get to know someone and like see what different songs people choose and how they explain themselves with this song. So before the hackathon, we made a playlist with all the 40 participants, and we were like, hey, this is all of you. This is a fun way for you to get to know each other and, you know, get a bit excited about the hack beforehand. And then during the hackathon, we opened up the playlist, so we made it collaborative, so everyone could add the music they wanted to listen to, which means that there was always something that you would like that will be playing in the speakers, because music is, you know, at least to me, very important, and it creates a very nice atmosphere. And this way we could also make sure that, you know, if you at least just like one song in a playlist, it's gonna play for you every now and then. So we evaluated this a bit afterwards, and we got some nice feedback, like, first time I worked in a team as balanced as this one, you know, when they had both designers and back-end and front-end knowing people. Thought it was great to skip the competition part because the event felt really relaxed and people could mingle around and look at everyone's stuff, which is great. That's really, you know, what we wanted to promote. And they really liked having a coach who's an employee and like we said that it was awesome getting feedback from real people in the biz. Because as a student, it's pretty difficult to know what is it like to actually work as a developer or as a designer. But now they could get like the real tips and tricks. Someone said that this is a proof of concept how good diversity is within the IT, because they built really cool stuff. Like, I'm jealous of the products that they built during these 2 days. Someone said that it's the most inspiring weekend in a long time. I'm so happy that we managed to inspire people and make them feel like, wow, this is amazing, I want to continue doing this. And then there's this quote that I really love. Someone, when we asked them to explain your weekend in one sentence, one person says, adventures happen if you let them. So we made a tech event, and this person saw this like that it's a great adventure, and that's awesome. Okay, but now we're thinking, okay, cool, Caroline, but not everything can be as awesome as jumping into a pool out from a window, right? No, that's true. There were some improvements we could do. So a few months later, we made another hackathon that we called Unify, which was more about collaborating and working in a big team. So we put them up in teams of 8. And we did the same thing here, like application, we assembled a team for them and things like that. But we did some changes to improve this further. First of all, we didn't want to force the 50-50 gender split. We wanted to see, like, did we really learn something from Diversify? Like, in terms of marketing and information, and turns out we did. We got a gender split both in applications and for the hackathon in 40% female and 60% male, which is great. I mean, the tech world isn't 50-50, but this is still pretty balanced compared to if we would have 10% female and 90% male. We also made the teams like platform specific, because while they did enjoy it, Diversify, that they could say, I want to do design, or I want to do backend, or I want to do frontend, some participants felt that, okay, I really wanted to do iOS development, but my team, they wanted to do web because they hadn't done iOS before. And this is a bit of a shame. So here, we also let the applicants say, like, okay, I want to do iOS, I want to do web, or I want to do Android. So we had like two web teams, we had one Android team and one iOS team. And that way, we made sure that if you like a backend, you could do backend, but then you would also work on the platform that you want to work on. And then we also combined the demos that we had with presentations on stage first. Because even though the demo format was great, some participants felt that they had to repeat themselves over and over again. You know, I would show something to a person here, then I would explain this app, you type in a city, and then you get the artist up there that's playing the next week, and then, you know, next person would come, and I would have to say the same thing over again. So instead, we had first like presentations on stage, just like show your product. This is what we learned. This is what we built, and then that way everyone could see it once, and then you can go around and play at the demo stations. That was all I was going to say now. If you want to go ahead and look at what they built during these two hackathons, we have two showcase sites. They're called diversify.github.io or spotify-unify.github.io. It's pretty cool. You can see what they built. If you want to reach out to me, I have an email address. It's arkinson@spotify.com. You can also poke me on Twitter. It's arky with a Y at the end. But please be aware, there may contain traces of cat images in my Twitter feed. And apart from that, I'm going to hang around here if you want to come talk to me or discuss whatever. Thanks for listening, and I hope you're having a great day.